Hello, class 4. So today we are going to continue with the different physical features of our country. Okay, so I hope you remember that we had read about the different landforms or the physical features that exist in our country, isn't it? So on the basis of these landforms only, like in some places we have deserts, some areas it is a plain, isn't it? So on the basis of this different physical features only, India has been divided into 6 different parts. We have the northern mountains, the northern plains, Great Indian Desert, southern plateaus, coastal plains and islands, isn't it? So these are the 6 different physical features that exist in our country. Now we have already read about the northern mountains in the previous class, isn't it? So today we are going to read about the northern plains. Okay, so now first we'll read about the extent of the northern plains. So northern plains, it exists from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. Okay, and the total width, the total length of the northern plain is approximately 2500 kilometers. Okay, so for you can refer to your map. Okay, map given on page 24 in your book also. You can see here. So here you can see. Okay, so the one here. From Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. Isn't it? So this here, the area in the green portion, this is the extent of the northern plains. Okay. So now, the northern plains are drained by many rivers. Okay, these rivers, it originates, it starts from the mountains. So while coming down through the northern plains, along with water, it also carries sand, mud, silt, clay, small pebbles along with them. Now, these materials, these sediments, it gets deposited on the banks. Okay, so thus making the northern plains very fertile. So remember, the northern plain region are very fertile regions. Okay, now the rivers that flows through the northern plains are the Ganga River, the Satluj, the Brahmaputra and its tributaries. Okay, now what is a tributary? A tributary is a small stream or a small river that flows and merge, it joins the main river. So this is a tributary. Okay, so the main rivers of the northern plains are the Ganga, the Satluj, the Brahmaputra and its tributaries. Okay, so now the area that is watered by the river, by a river, it is called the river basin. Okay, and there are 3 important river basins in the northern plain, in the northern plains: the Satluj river basin, the Ganga river basin and the Brahmaputra river basin. Okay, so first we'll read about the Satluj river basin. Now the western part of the northern plain, it is watered by river Satluj. Okay, so that's why this area is known as the Satluj river basin. Okay, the states of Punjab and Haryana are a part of the Satluj river basin. And the Bhakra dam, I hope you have heard about the Bhakra dam. Bhakra dam has been built across this river Satluj, and this dam, it provides water for irrigation as well as for producing electricity. Okay, got it. So now the Ganga river basin. Now the central part of the northern plain, it is watered by river Ganga. So that's why this area is known as the Ganga river basin. Now the states of West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, it is a part of the Ganga river basin. Okay, so now we are reading about the Ganga river basin. Okay, so the Ganga river, it originates from the Gangotri glacier and it flows down through as the Bhagirathi river. Now on its journey from the mountains to the sea, the Ganga river is joined by many tributaries like the Ghagra, Ghomti, Koshi, Yamuna, San, Chambal, Betwa. All these are tributaries that joins the Ganga river. Okay, and remember, among all these tributaries, the Yamuna is a main tributary of the river Ganga. The Yamuna river, it joins Ganga river at Prayagraj, Allahabad. Okay, and the meeting point of Yamuna and Ganga, it is known as Sangam. Okay, now the last part of the Ganga's journey is through West Bengal. Here the Ganga river, it flows down slowly and it splits into many distributaries. Okay, the Hooghly is one of the main distributary of river Ganga. Okay, and the city of Kolkata is also situated on the banks of the river Hooghly only. Okay, and one distributary of the river Ganga, it enters into Bangladesh, where it is known as the Padma river. Got it? So now we'll read about the Brahmaputra River basin. Okay. So now the Brahmaputra River basin, the eastern part of the northern plain, okay, it is watered by river Brahmaputra. So that's why it is known as the Brahmaputra River basin. So now the Brahmaputra River, it originates in Tibet, okay, where it is called Tsangpo. The Brahmaputra River, it enters into India through Arunachal Pradesh, okay, and it flows down through Assam before it enters into Bangladesh. Got it? Now, the Brahmaputra River, it joins the Padma River and it forms the largest delta in the world, that is the Sundarban Delta, before falling into the Bay of Bengal. Okay? Okay, so now let's read about the life of the people living in the northern plains. Now, you know that the northern plains are very fertile regions, so therefore it is very, it is thickly populated. Okay, lots of people, they live in the northern plains region. Okay, and agriculture is the main occupation of the people living in the northern plains. The states that lie in the northern plains are Haryana, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, isn't it? Then you have some parts of West Bengal, Assam, Bihar also. Okay, and even the Union Territory of Delhi is situated, lies in the northern plain region. Okay, so now there are different, let us study about the life of the people living in different states that lie in the northern plains. Okay.